Hi there, Danica here, and in this video, we will be checking out a plugin that I recommend you use if you are looking for a free one to protect your website content, so for your members area. So there's also just a note that there is a free version and there's a paid version, and I'm gonna demonstrate to you both sides, and I think this is gonna be a bi-topic video, so watch out on the next one after this. But for this one, I'd like to introduce WP Fusion. So I use WP Fusion. I think I started last year. I did hear a lot of good things about it before, but haven't really used it in my projects because most of the time I'm using Memberium. It's usually Memberium, and then before that I had iMember 360, Active Member 360, Access Ally. But WP Fusion, I just started using this in my projects last year, and I simply just could say like I highly recommend it. And there's a lot of things or lots of reason why. Again, we're gonna go over with those. But if you have any question regarding WP Fusion, please comment it down below and I'll do my best to share my experience with it. And yep, let's just get started. So again, I recommend this. This video, we're gonna focus on using this for free. So we're gonna use the light version. And also I'm recommending this if you are just like beginning in your membership site journey or selling your courses and you're wondering how to protect your content inside your membership site. Whether you get the paid version or start with the lite, it is okay, because when you're ready to upgrade, the paid version will also do a lot of things regarding your setup. Okay, so let's check out the free version first and what it does. So go to wpfusion.com, and if you click get started, you should see a link to download the free version. You could also search it in the WordPress plugin directory, WP Fusion Lite, and install it to your website. Now, one of the great thing with WP Fusion is it supports a lot of CRMs. Now, in most of my setups, like I think 90% of the time, all of them are using different kinds of CRMs, whether that's Keep, Active Campaign, Fluencer M, or what else, like even the Go High level. So the reason for that is the client used that to manage your contact records, right? So we want to make sure that this tool is synchronized. So if they have this tag, give this access. If they don't, then do this, etc. And WP Fusion could do that and communicate well with your website in base of what details you have for your contact records in your CRM system, whether that's built in under WordPress like Fluencer M or Jetpack, or a different or outside one, which is example Active Campaign or Keep. And again, it just supports this list of CRMs. If you go to this link, you could check out what CRM does WP Fusion supports, and you could see what are the functionality that it can do, whether that supports event tracking, enhance e-commerce, add new tags in WordPress, webhook, and what they rated it with. So example, Active Campaign, they support all of the column in here, while others are only few, or maybe they're just working on it and developing. You could also see like Groundhog. You could also see FluencerM in here that is also supported. You could also see like Jetpack in here. It says not yet available in terms of webhook, and I think that's because Jetpack is directly like integrated in your WordPress site. But in our demo today, we will be using Jetpack to check out the free version. So check out this page if you are wondering what CRM does WP Fusion support. Okay, so after you install your WP Fusion Lite, you should see under your settings this WP Fusion added. So that is your WP Fusion installed. And also before that, I installed the Jetpack CRM in this demo site. So install or set up your CRM first, and then install WP Fusion and it will ask what CRM are you using in the very beginning when you click this link. And in my case, I selected Jetpack CRM. After setting that up, it will reload the page and it will give you all of these options right here. So you could do or check out what it does and it doesn't. But for now, I'm just gonna leave this as default. But you can see that you could like assign a tag to all of your contacts. I mean, whenever you create a contact, you could also restrict the content, which is the super important one that we want this part. And then you could also decide how to hide your content and other stuff here that I usually or that usually exist in these membership plugins like Memberium, which is great. If they don't have access to the content, like if they don't have that right tag, because WP Fusion is based on a tag, if they don't have that tag, you could select like where to redirect them or what message would like to show. There's also an option to apply a tag once a member is locked out, so you could monitor them or track them whenever you need to. And then at the bottom, there's also an option to return password to your CRM account if you want. But I usually don't turn this on just for privacy purpose. So I could just deactivate this so that their password is private to them and they can manage it from their end. So these are the settings that I will like leave and turn on for now. And let's just jump into a page that I'd like to demonstrate how this works. So I forgot to show you what I have in Jetpack CRM. So I have a sample contact here. No tags yet, but we're gonna check it out and apply a tag and see what will happen. So I have this page and I'm using a shortcode from, let me just zoom in. So I'm using a shortcode from WP Fusion, and what it does is it's a conditional shortcode that again usually exists with these membership plugins that I have used, like Memberium, Access Ally, and other stuff. They have this. If they have this tag, show this message. If they don't, show this. And you could check out these links for the complete tags that they have. I'm gonna attach this in the description so that you could visit the page. Okay, so what I'm trying to do is I want to show this message, the one above, if they have the tag, and this one if they don't. Okay, so we're gonna try this out. So first, I am in the website, logged in as a test account, and this is the page that we added the shortcode. If I refresh, it says you don't have access to the freestyle basic resources. I'm gonna get this message. And that's because I don't have the tag. Now, other than shortcode, you could also protect the entire page using this option. But we're gonna check it out after this one. So let's just test this first. I'm gonna apply this tag to my user. So I'm gonna edit this contact. And I have this tag already added earlier. So I'm just gonna save that. Now I'm gonna go back in here. And as you can see, it now says you have access to the freestyle basic content. So the message has changed and it's because of that shortcode. So that's an example of how this shortcode works. And again, they have a list of shortcodes that you can check out. So if you have any question with this one or section, just let me know. We're gonna go and after that, so that's how you dynamically or conditionally show a specific content if they have the proper access via tags based on your setup. The next is we want to example user must log in. So I'm just going to remove this first. So we could check this, and what's going to happen is it says user must log in to view this page. So if I just update that and I'm gonna go back in here and I'm gonna log out. And I'm gonna log in again. And then I'm going to access that resource page that we want. So I could access the page without any problem, right, as a login member. Now, if I log out and paste that link, it says, oops, you don't have permission to view this page. You need to log in to contact the support or contact the support. So we are requiring them to log in to view this page. Now, in this section, it says redirect if access is denied. So you can also set that up. Other than that, you can also go to the restriction section in WP Fusion. And in here, you want to, let's just say, redirect them to a page. So let's just say I'm going to redirect them to this link. Save changes. So I'm going to reload this page again. And it redirected to the link that we set. So this could be your landing page. This could be your opt-in page, depending on your setup. So it's very nice that it has this functionality already for free in their light version. And that's why I highly recommend it. And of course, if you remove that, only the oops message will show up. So I go to that page again. It just says, oops, you need to log in to access the content. Now, how about this tag side? So it says we could set like required tags. So if they have any of the tag, then allow them to access other than them log in. So you need to check this so that this fields will work or else it will be grayed out. And you could also see like there's a required tag all. There's also required tag. So if they don't have that, do this, etc. But we're going to start with this first field. So I want that only those who have the Freestyle Basic could access this resources. So I'm going to update that. So even if I'm logged in, if I refresh, it still says, oops, you don't have access because I don't have the proper tag. Now, if I apply the tag to my contact here,
a few moments later.
Okay, so it's not showing up because we need to resync the tag. So I'm gonna do that again. Hold on. So click save and refresh. And then apply that tag again. And then I'm gonna go to refresh. If I resync this, it's still not working, so I'm just gonna log out. Let's try to troubleshoot why this is not working. And now it says you have access to the Freestyle Basics. So this one is if I'm in active campaign with the WP Fusion, I'm gonna run a webhook to contact update record whenever you remove and add a contact tag so that they don't need to log out and log in, because the solution that worked when we were testing this in a few seconds ago is I just needed to log out and log in again. But with Jet Engine, they noted in their CRM table that it doesn't support the webhook. So just a note on that one. But if you are using like active campaign or keep, they do have a webhook for updating the contact record. So again, once the tag has changed or removed or applied again to their record, they don't need to log out and log in to see their latest access. But I think for a free version, that is okay, right? Because I mean, you could just add instruction to your member, put some note like in the FAQ section, especially if you don't want to spend any dime yet for this plugin to just to protect your content. For me, it's still very good one, although with Jetpack CRM, you could see that it doesn't allow us to run some webhook to update the contact record.
A few moments later.
Okay, so when looking at the issue that we had experienced, I found out this section here. So it says bi-directional sync with CRM. So I think it should solve the issue that we had earlier. And let's test this out. So I'm just gonna call exactly the same tag that we had. And I'm gonna save these changes. And again, I'm gonna remove this. So problems like this, I really want to show how I troubleshoot it and what I discover. So it says, oops, you don't have access. Now let's try that again. And we're going to apply the tag and see if we still need to log out and log in just to have the latest access. Okay, so that solves the problem. So that's how you could solve that synchronization problem with Jetpack CRM and WP Fusion, which is cool. So we get that handle, it's working now. Now last but not the least, I want to also try this different URL field. So other than the settings in here, right, where we could add a redirect URL and we have set this, right? So I also want to show that there's a section that you could assign to this example, these resources only. And the reason for example usage for this is maybe if your generic landing page is different from this individual resources or content that they should access. So if they don't have access to this specific one, maybe you want them to redirect to a specific landing page other than this generic one that you will set in here. Here. So let's try that. So I'm going to copy this link and I'm just going to enter that below. And again, I'm going to remove the tag from my end, from my test user, I mean. And then I'm going to refresh. And it got us redirected to that link that we assigned. So it's working. And other than that, these are the other fields that you could check out or are available in the Lite version. So again, that's why I highly recommend this plugin if you're starting out with your membership content or course creation journey and you want to make sure that you protect your resources and content properly. Now, this is for the Lite version and I'm going to record more tutorials for the paid one. So stay tuned for that. But yeah, I hope this video helps and you've seen how we have compared or troubleshoot different scenarios that we have bumped into during this process and what are the options or settings that we did to solve it. So again, if you have any question regarding WP Fusion, just let me know. Please comment it down below and I'll try to share my experience with it. This is the first time that I've used it with Jetpack CRM, but if you're using it with Active Campaign and Keep, I think it's gonna be very powerful because they have this webhooks and it does just communicate it properly. Plus it also supports your e-commerce. So if you're using WooCommerce, you could also apply tag when they purchase and use that tag to open a content or access and use that tag so that your member could access that content that they just purchased from you. So that's it. Thanks for watching and I'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.